Very good morning, students. Let's start our English class. So, students, in our last class, we had completed story reading, chapter explanation of this chapter 3, Raju's Hero. And I send you all the question and answers of this chapter, question and answers and word meanings of this chapters. I hope you all can see the screen that is clear. And I told you to complete the multiple choice question by yourself. I hope you all have completed that. Move to the exercise of this chapter, students. So let's start completing the exercise. Open page number 38 of this chapter, grammar. Here we'll study about although and yet. That where we have to use although and where we have to use yet. Read these sentences. Although Anu was small, yet she helped Granny. Although Anu was small, she helped Granny. Anu helped Granny although she was small. Important. Although can be placed either at the beginning of the sentence or towards the end. So this is the rule for adding although, for putting although in the sentence. At where we can put although. Although means in Hindi we can say the meaning of although is jabki. We can say jabki. Sometimes we use na this type of jabki wo aisa hai to wo waisa bhi hai. Usne aisa kiya lekin usne aisa bhi kiya jabki. So like this we can use although. It's a kind of a clause, word clause which we can use here. So where we have to use although, although is used in the beginning of the sentence and also to the towards the end. Like you can see in the beginning of the sentence is although and in the end also. Yet can be used with although but not necessarily. Yet jo hai although ke saath use ho sakta hai but it's not necessary to use that. Match to make complete sentence. Here we have to match them to make them a complete sentence. So let's complete this exercise, students, with me. So here, the first one is, although he got up in time, yet he was late for office. Let's match it. Although he got late up, he got up in time, yet he was late. Although the car had a puncture, yet we reached in time. Yet we reached in time. Although the children went to the zoo, they could see many animals. Although it is raining heavily, yet the boys are in the park. Understand? I hope that you all have done this exercise. Let's move to the next exercise. Here, complete these sentences. Although the bag was heavy. Now here we have to complete these exercises through our sentences. We have to put our sentences. So let's write them. Although the bag was heavy, yet he walked quickly. Full stop. So students, the next question is dash yet he jumped into the pool. And the answer is although the water was cold, although the water was cold, yet he jumped into the pool. Next is, although he lost his money, yet he was not discouraged. Full stop. Next is, although he had no time, although he had no time, yet he went to the circus. Although it was a difficult paper, yet he could solve it easily. Full stop. I hope that you all have completed this exercise. Move to the next exercise. So students, let's move to the next exercise, which is, here you have to fill in the blanks again with although and yet. That where we have to put although and where we have to put yet. So let's complete this exercise. Although the tortoise was slow, yet he won the race. The car was small, yet we all fitted in it. My brother gave me his sandwich, although he himself was very angry. They carried an umbrella, dash, they got wet in the rain. They carried an umbrella, yet they got wet in the rain. Dash, the food was delicious, I could not eat much. Although the food was delicious, I could not eat much. This is the answer of exercise number C. Let's move to the exercise number A of learn new words. Let's complete this chapter then. We can complete a poem also today because we have, I think, sufficient time. I hope you all have completed. Move to the next exercise, learn the new words. Here we just have to give in the following description of 5 words. You just have to write the one word for these following sentences. Like you can see, a beautiful flower that comes in many colors. So the answer is rose. Rose comes in many colors, like, but the word, each word must begin with R. This is the condition. Then that each word must start with R. So the first is already done. But next one is water falling in the drops of clouds. So here the answer is rain. Rain. Next is a part of the plant that usually grow underground. The part of the plant that usually grow underground is
ma'am, root.
Yes, it's root. I hope you all can see the screen. Root, R-O-O-T, root. The circular band of metal used burn on finger. That is ring. The first one was rain. Next is root. Third is ring. Fourth is space that may or may not be occupied. That is room. And next is relaxation, that is called refresh. I hope you all have done this exercise too. Let's move to the next exercise. Fill in the blanks with the opposites of the words in the red. Here we just have to find out, right? We have to find out the opposites of the words which are written in red. The baby was crying, but as soon as he saw his mother, he started crying. Opposite of crying is laughing. Yes, Hari, I told the answer. Down your hand. L-A-U-G-H-I-N-G. Laughing. Next is Ravi dashed his pen yesterday, but his friend found it. So you're lost. All the children wore new clothes except for James. He wore his old clothes. Borrowed. He borrowed his book from the library, but forget to return. R-E-T-U-R-N. Return. I hope you all can see the screen and complete this exercise. I hope you completed this exercise. I'm giving you this exercise as your assignment because it's very simple. You have to rewrite the passage using full stop and capital. Understand? Here this passage you have to rewrite using full stop and capital. Now here you have to just correct the spelling of the word which are given here. Favorite ki spelling correct likhiye. Naughty, grandparent and delight. You have to find out the correct meaning and write down here. Understand? Write down the correct. I'm sorry. It's a spelling, not meaning. Understand? Favorite, the correct spelling of the word you have to write here. The correct spelling of naughty you have to write here. Correct spelling of grandparent you have to write here. And correct spelling of delight you have to write here. Move to the next poem. Let's complete the poem also. We have 10 minutes, even more. We can complete this one also today. So move to the poem. As you can see on your screen, Grandpa dropped his glasses. Let me explain this poem to you all. First of all, Grandpa dropped his glasses once in a pot of dye, and when he put them on again, he saw a purple sky. Purple fires were rising up from a purple hill. Men were grinding purple cider at the purple mill. Purple Adeline was playing with a purple doll. Little purple dragonfly were crawling up the wall. And at the supper table, he got crazy as a loon from eating purple apple dumpling with a purple spoon. So here you can see this poem is about that. What do you think had happened when grandfather wore purple colored glasses? Actually, there was a color of purple dye color was on the ball or a pot, and grandpa's glasses were just fell on that. Grandpa picked them up and just wore it. So because of that, grandpa can see everything in purple color. Everything, whatever he just see from his spectacles, from his glasses, they were just purple. As you can see, Adeline as his granddaughter, she was playing with a purple doll. Mountains are purple. Everything here is purple. The purple fires were rising from the hill. Men were grinding cider. You can see men were grinding cider here. Here you can see dragonfly, that is also purple. Purple mills, the mills over here you can see, they all are purple. So basically this poem is about that grandpa's purple glasses, which fell on the pot, which is filled with a purple dye. Purple dye means it's a kind of color which elders put on their hair. Understand? Now this poem is all about this, and here is the name of this poet, which is Leroy F. Jackson. The poet's name is Leroy F. Jackson. And students, you all have to write and learn the word meanings which are given here on your notebook. Understand, this is your homework, that you all have to write the word meanings which are given here on your notebook. If you have any doubt, then just tell me. Friends, you all have to write the poem on your notebook and you have to draw the picture over here on your notebook. Understand? Yes, Rishabh. So students, you all have to draw this picture over here on your notebook in a very beautiful, neat and clear way, colorful way. You have to write down this poem on your notebook and you have to learn 8 lines of this poem and the name of this poet, which is important. Write down the word meanings which are given here. Understand? You have to write down the word meanings which are given here. Instead of, don't wait for me, that ma'am will send some another meaning. These are the word meanings which are important and which you have to learn. Next, move to the exercise, a little more of the poem. Where did grandpa drop his glasses? The question is. So what did he see first? What did he first see when he put them on? Let me show you the answer of this question. So students, question number first is, where did grandpa drop his glasses? What did he see first when he put them on? You can see the answer is over here. Grandpa dropped his glasses in a pot of dye when he put them on. He first saw the purple sky. This is answer number one. Understand? I hope you all have written the answer number one. Move to the next question, which is, who do you think is Adeline? Adeline is his granddaughter. The answer is simply, Adeline is his granddaughter. Next question number three. What was Adeline playing with? What is the answer? Who can tell me the right answer? What was Adeline playing
with? Purple doll.
Purple doll. Yes, she was playing with purple doll.
During what part of the day?
Oh, sorry.
Morning, evening, night, afternoon.
Next, during what part of the day do you think grandpa dropped his glasses? Morning, evening, night, or afternoon? In which part?
Ma'am, morning.
Yes, morning.
Ma'am, morning.
Next question. Read these sentences that tells us what happened when grandpa wore his purple colored glasses. But the sentence are not correct. Rewrite the sentence correctly. Here you have to write the sentence correctly. So the purple fire were rising up at the purple mill. The answer, the sentence is not in a correct way. So here we have to write, the purple fire were rising up from a purple hill. Understand? Remove mill. Here from. From a purple hill, H-I-L-L, hill, full stop. This is the correct sentence, correct line. Purple Adeline was playing with a purple spoon. So in place of a spoon, we have to write doll. Because Adeline was playing with a doll, full stop. Next, men were grinding purple cider with a purple doll. With a purple, men were grinding purple cider at a purple mill. Full stop. Sixth question.
Ma'am,
I told you that you all have to complete sixth question by yourself. Here you just have to write the actual, the real colors, the natural colors of skies, hills, sky and fire. Yes.
Ma'am, we have to do question number 5 in copy.
Yes, you have to do question number 5 in copy, question number 6 in your notebook. Question number 7. Yes, in question number 7 is to color the picture with red. Picture is over here, which is given, which that color you all have to do with red. Understand? I hope you all have completed, students. So let's meet in our next class, and from next class we'll start completing grammar. Understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Rishabh.
Yes, Rishabh.